Prison break. Prison break. All of the prisoner has managed to escape somehow, and she's picked up a bow. I'm glad she didn't pick up the minigun.
I wanted to convert you, Olive. I wanted you to be a productive member of society, and I have forgotten now. Oh, Solar, you have no skill whatsoever in anything but melee. Hey, we have a Plasteel Gladius. Why haven't I given that to anyone yet? Talia, you deserve it. You earned it. This is your promotion. This is your upgrade after that insect fight. Also got the Plasteel Knife. That's what Ivana's going to take on from this point forward. But before we do that, I actually probably need both of you. Now let's just get all the gun wielders to melee. Wake up, melee attack. Wake up, melee attack. Wake up, melee attack, and we're gonna beat you down till you submit. Everyone together now. From all walks of life, we're going to unite. The alarm has sounded. How are the doors opening for you? Do we not lock those at night? Ivana, not you though. We don't want to stab her to death. Ivana doesn't care what I have to say. She's just staying right here. Continuing to stab Olive. I don't know why. We just wanted to shiv her because she broke out of prison. I guess, if nothing else, the shiv was probably the most applicable. Okay. Somebody does need to rescue Olive, though. That's important. Capture Olive. Taz, I know you want to set things on fire, but you can't do that. Well, now I know why we probably need to put doors on the stockpile room here. So why don't we go ahead and do that now, so that in the future any prison breakers can't take our good weapons and try to escape with them. Skipping ahead in time a bit here, there's a few new developments I think you need to be made retroactively aware of. One is that Ivana's going around and healing all those who have been wounded in that prison escape attempt. Two is that our hydroponics chamber is now bearing its first harvest of potatoes and rice, and I fully intend to change a number of these hydroponic basins into rice basins instead of potatoes, because they apparently benefit more from the fertility of the hydroponics. Three is that our batteries are doing better than ever before, because we now have four functioning solar generator panels to complement our array of eight wind turbines. And that's giving us consistent energy production during the day. Right now we're sitting at a stock 435, and what is that infernal screeching noise? Oh, there's an army of boom rats outside the doors, screeching and squealing, peeping and pooping everywhere, waiting for one of us to slip and fall, to accidentally open the door so they can boom on us all. I'm not gonna do that though. Everyone is restricted to Area 1 right now. Not a very big area, mind you, but it's about to be expanded quite a bit because we do have a lot of space that's walled in down here that I'm not too worried about them walking around in. These little guys came in and scurried from off map, man-hunting boom rats. They want and smell our human flesh, and I will not give it to them. And there's far too many out here to try to fight. So in the meantime, we have to listen to this incessant noise. If I zoom out far enough, maybe they will shut up. I'm just gonna fast forward through. Talia, you scared me there. I know you're just gonna play horseshoes, but you scared me just a little bit. We'll fast forward until this danger passes and everyone can go back outside and resume their normal duties. Luckily, we're fairly self-sufficient in here. I'm also digging out a brand new room I may have forgotten to mention. This is going to be overflow stockpile for our weapons. See how all of these shelves are full up? That's what this is going to be all about. Solar's in here hard at work, helping us out, mining, Talia, cleaning up behind. We obviously need to haul some of these rocks, but we can't do that just yet because the haul point's outside and we can't quite get there, can we? And to make matters worse, looks like the refrigerator is full. We're just gonna have to cook all this meat up into meals. Which reminds me, it's high time that we up our cooking finesse. That we change the bill or add another bill. We're cooking simple meals, sure, but why not cook better? Fine meals. We're not going to bump it up to lavish just yet, but we will cook a whole slew of fine meals. I'm going to say 25, 30. We'll just do 30 of both. 30 simple, 30 fine. That'll be a lot of backup food for us. It'll be frozen and ready to eat. Let's go ahead and expand all these menus so we can see what kind of drugs we got, what kind of linens we have. Too many different types of meat stuff. So the goal here in making fine meals is that these are gonna make our colonists a lot happier to eat. Unfortunately, there's nowhere to put the fine meals, so they're just gonna spoil in 3 days unless we find a place for them to go. I'm hoping though that we can take some of this meat and make some room for a new stack of 10 fine meals. But the difference between fine and simple is not just in terms of how happy it makes your colonists, but also what it requires to cook. So a fine meal is gonna require half vegetable and half meat. So when possible, we're gonna make fine meals, but when not possible, we'll still have simple meals, which can do all of either. It's a little bit more lenient with what ingredients it requires. So we got the vegetables here, and we got the meat here. Now I'm gonna go through the painstaking, laborious process of selecting each one of these hydroponics basins and switching things over to rice. I mentioned that they benefit a bit more from having the fertility bestowed upon it from the hydroponic basins, but to go into a little bit more detail, let's take a look. What was that? What? Why is a boomalope out here fighting Opal the dog? Opal, stay inside of Area 1. Get back in the house before you die. Stop fighting. No, the boomalope, boom rat's done. Just go indoors. And I have to hope that the Area 1 also is for food. Okay, it is good. They're still screeching outside. Anyway, what was I saying? Right, let's take a look at potatoes. Potatoes have a 40% soil fertility sensitivity. That's, I suppose, the bonus that they receive from fertile soil. Rice, on the other hand, has a 100% bonus. That's why when we take a look at rice in this menu, you can see that it is growing at 230% growth rate, whereas potatoes are only doing 152. So rice is just so much faster and better, and drug production research is complete, and we can make a drug lab. Further research is required to make specific drugs, but the basics of drug prep and synthesis is ready. Don't know exactly what that means. We're gonna take a look through the architect menu and try to find some new buildings. Now we can do Go Juice production, performance enhancing drugs. What other new drugs do we get? Malaria blockers. This prevents malaria. Reasonable, right? What? Psychite refining? Of course. Learn to refine psychoid leaves into flake and yayo. Those are very addictive drugs. What was I going to do before? Microelectronic basics, so that we can start trading all these things through the comms console. So that's next, obviously, on the agenda. Our fine meals are being consumed, and I want to check on them to see what type of moodlet it confers. Feeling good. Ate a fine meal. There it is. +5 positive mood for 12 hours. Ate a real tasty meal. Yum. I feel the same way. We've also made some room in the refrigerator for the fine meals. They're refrigerated now, 9 days instead of 3. I don't know why it's so warm in here. I guess because the door keeps getting open and closed. Let's see, it's bouncing around 40. I think our cooler should be working just fine. 40 in there, 70 in here. Maybe the hot air is just seeping in. I don't know. But I guess refrigerated's better than nothing. Maybe I should turn this down even more than usual. Let's do minus, or 16 degrees Fahrenheit, rather. I don't know, we'll have to keep an eye on that. Anyway, taking a look back down here at our mining project, it's gonna take us quite some time. Probably need to start proactively adding some power conduit down the length of the hallway so we can add some lights so these people aren't stuck in the dark forever. Seems like a pretty good idea. Might even dig a couple of notches into the wall. I do enjoy doing that. Let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, and the 5th and 6th spots. I'm gonna dig out. We can put a lamp and maybe a potted plant down here. Let's do 5 more. We struck compacted machinery.
I don't know when we'll be able to use that, assuming when we do a little bit more research. Friendlies. A group of friendly outlanders have arrived. They're moving in to help you immediately. They are going to fight the boom rats. Oh, this I gotta see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do a couple more spaces. And then the last two. And eventually this hallway's gonna go a little bit further down because it's very off-kilter for the time being. But that's okay. Where are these friendlies? 4 of them in total. What are they armed with? You guys better have some good gear. No weapon. No weapon. Oh, wait, no. Pistol. Pistol. Nothing. And a steel club. So a couple of pistols think they're gonna take down all these boom rats. This I gotta see. I'm not gonna help you whatsoever. I did not call for this aid. They have sent a task force of sorts. And I don't think this is gonna go well for them. I think they're all gonna die. Pirate merchant from McCout's Hamlet. They will hang around the colony for a few days. More people all coming in at the same time. Well, here goes the fight. Mitch is trying to pistol whip a bunch of boom rats. He just exploded and caught fire. The other 3 are getting swarmed. 4 boom rats are surrounding Grill right now. Mitch the sniper is dead. Jude is going to be next. Grill's dead. JC is the last survivor. They've managed to take down 2 boom rats, and that's it. That's all they got. That was a good effort, but unfortunately, it's not looking too promising. We got another large group. This one's coming along with some Arctic wolves as bodyguards. That's more respectable. You have a better chance. You're all gonna catch fire and probably die, but I think you'll take a few more boom rats out with you. Let's fast forward and find out. Meanwhile, the colonists are just keeping themselves nice and busy in here. In the meantime, oh, too fast. They've got plasteel gladiuses, extinguishing fires, assault rifles. Ooh, you guys are fancy. The dromedary pets are struggling a bit. They're trying to catch our colony on fire by the looks of things. Korgar, the grunt, lying on the ground, burning along with Eaton, the inventor. But it appears that this group of traitors may be winning, if you can call this winning. Most of them are burning to death right now. General, however, is still alive. Sam is still fine. So even though they're too dumb to put their friends' fires out, most of them will live. Actually, General just walked into the fire and caught fire and may end up dying if he can't put this out. Stop, drop, and roll, man. Stop, drop, and roll. Rip Eaton? Korgar. Mantis, you look like you're about to die. Denardo, and more. There go. I wish the traitor had died. If the traitor died, at least, we would have been able to take all of their goods. I think all the boom rats are dead, though, so everyone else has unrestricted movement throughout the colony. So too does our pet. Now, let's try to remember who is the best talker. Most talking skills looks like Dinah the Drifter, so we're going to send you outside, hopefully not catch fire, and trade if possible. Don't know how much we actually have to trade. A few of our other colonists will set about putting the fires out on the dead traders. Are you trying to tell me that 1 smoke leaf joint to you is $20, but you want a minigun? You're gonna give me $16? I could only buy like 2 Big Mac meals with that much money. You understand? And maybe like a couple of apple pies. That's not enough. On the other hand, we got Olive, who attempted to escape from our prison cells after we treated her so nicely. She's worth $647 on the slave trade market. I'm not gonna lie, I'm tempted. She does have some good character stats. 10 in melee, kind of amazing. 11 social skill, even pretty good shooter. Do we need that shooter? But do we need someone who abhors the idea of gaining pleasure from chemicals, avoids alcohol and pleasurable drugs? It's kind of what this colony is all about now. I think I'm gonna sell her off. Our colonists may not be too happy about that fact, but I think it's necessary that she stands against what our colony stands for. I'm gonna buy a Kevlar helmet too. There's not very much money in return. There's not much else we can buy, truth be told. But I think that's about all I want. So have a good one, Olive. You're free to go. Say hello to your new masters, the slave traders over here. I'm surprised they weren't selling any guns or anything like that. I guess that implicates us in the slave trade a little bit too, doesn't it? But she did try to escape. This is my revenge. We had another boom rat explosion outside, and another one of the traitor colonists caught fire, so I'm gonna bring that person back to health and just release them back into the wild. This is not a capture, it's just a rescue. Just a quick little heal from these burns and set back out into the wild to improve our reputation with that other friendly neighbor. Now back here, we almost have our new arms room set and ready to go. So we have some furniture, and I guess, do we have to build these out of steel? Seems like such a waste of steel, but we don't have any wood whatsoever. Huh. That is why we need to figure out how to make granite and slate blocks. That's a crafting deal. I'm gonna try wood for now, and we'll see what we can get. How much room do we have here? I guess enough for four on each side, and we'll probably have a lamp up there at the top. Disease and plague! Dinah has gotten sick from a plague. Talia has gotten sick from a plague. That better not kill off my colonists, or I will be very upset. We need more medical beds, it seems. We don't have any prisoners right now, so we may as well have dedicated medical beds. Let's take a look at what this plague is. It needs proper treatment. Stoned on smoke leaf. And has the plague, of course. But that smoke leaf will make you feel a lot better, won't it? I think we're probably out. Was that the last blunt? Suhav has gotten sick from infection. Suhav, are you the one that brought this plague into the colony? Did we rescue you and in doing so endanger everyone here? Possibly. Our first batch of heal root is almost done growing. We're keeping it fairly warm inside, 66 degrees right now. 59 in here thanks to the cold snap. Looks like we need more heaters. I'm gonna have to get right on that because we don't want anyone to freeze to death indoors, do we? Let's put a heater back in here. We're trying to spread this out a little bit if we can. It's the third of spring, but you wouldn't know it thanks to all the gentle snow and the cold snaps and the 4 degrees Fahrenheit outside. Gonna work on building a roof here to try to warm us up in case we need to use this as a defensible position. I wanna start setting up some steel some steel deadfall traps here pretty soon as well. Don't know exactly how to go about doing that. I need to come up with a little maze. That's kind of the new plan. So the idea would be something like this. Let's just test it out, yeah? We would have a wall here. Maybe cancel one spot, or maybe not. Cancel two. Then, in the security tab, let's do two steel deadfall traps on either side. But then this spot will be open, and there will be a door that only we can go through. It's not a lot, but it is a start. This is poorly thought through and not at all efficient. But you gotta start somewhere, I say. That's where I'm gonna begin. The idea being, we don't want our own colonists to step through the deadfall traps. They can just go through the extra door. And the other people will have to walk through this string of deadfall traps when they go around the side to try to get to our main primary door. The plague is still being treated, but our first batch of heal root, 96% done. Major break risk. Talia, not feeling great. Urgently hungry, you say. Well, who is our warden, Dinah? Who also has the plague. Maybe we need another warden. What are you doing, Taz? Why don't you go get some fine meals from the refrigerator and feed these fine people before they starve to death on their medical beds? This plague actually has me quite worried. Dinah has major plague, whole body plus 35% pain. Next treatment in 10 hours. She is developing an immunity, but it is quite slow. Talia, same deal. Major plague. This is my only hope. Heal root. Come on, baby. I don't think this is gonna be the saving grace for the colony, but you gotta start somewhere. And this starting at 99%. Waiting on it to become harvestable. Our research on microelectronics is almost done too. Ready to harvest. Who is our crop grower? Polo, I know you're hungry, but you need to get down here and prioritize harvesting this heal root again. and again. And one more time, please, if you'd be so kind.
There we go.
4 fresh heal root. I think Talia just received some heal root treatment.
And we've got a mental break. The sad wanderer, Solar, the chef, very depressed right now. In a moderate amount of pain from the plague. So it begins. Could the colony be crumbling from this plague? Or will we be able to overcome it through a few more herbal treatments? We got more heal root on the way, but these aren't going to be ready for at least another day.
I don't know where we're going to be going from here, but I just have to hope that they'll develop an immunity, get over it, and everyone will be just fine. Man down, I repeat, we have a man down due to the plague. Extreme, untreated. Dinah has been incapacitated by the plague. Ivana's going to have to come rescue her. I'm scared. Someone hold me. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Etalyx. Find out what happens to the colony next time in RimWorld.